Thank you. I told you it would not disappoint. You know, someone just gave me this piece of paper that was being given out at a synagogue. The Pamela Geller controversy. It should say non-troversy. We all know that hate mongering leads to persecution and stereotyping is evil. Okay. But before Geller's cliches on honor killing, if I had never heard an inhumane statement before, that's it. These girls that are slaughtered because they don't want to wear hijab or they want to lead a Western life. So my cliche lies on honor killing, female genital mutilation, oh, that too is a lie. Although we know that 96% of the girls in Egypt have been clitorectomized, okay? They are, because I call attention to this grotesque human rights abuse, oppression of women, stoning. Okay, that's all, what is it? Cliche lies. Tell that to the millions of dead. Tell that to the voiceless that can't speak. I mean, okay, a little bit of research tells you that the other world religions are much more violent. Okay?
Oh,
again,
my God.
Again, A is not A.
What's in
that? A is not A. The Old Testament has much more violent verses than the New Testament and the Quran. Excuse me, but I do not see Jews killing other people or going into pizza parlors, strapping one on, screaming, Hashem Akbar! You do not see Christians running around killing people, screaming, Jesus Akbar! I mean, so this is patently dishonest. I don't care what it says. The difference is, in the Old and New Testaments, the violence is descriptive. In the Quran, the violence is prescriptive. Do you understand the difference?
Yes.
Yeah, well, they don't want you to understand the difference. Orthodox Judaism treats its women far more harshly than Islam. Why does not Geller launch a movement to save Orthodox Jews? Because I don't have to. Because if they don't want to do it, they can leave and nobody's going to kill them. That's the line. The line is compulsion. The line is force. If you don't want to live as an Orthodox Jew, Jewess, then you leave. End of story. In many circumstances, if you don't want to live as a Muslima, you're killed. We have seen a spike in honor killings in this country. Aksa Parvez, Amina and Sarah Saeed, Noor al-Maliki, Asia Hassan. I mean, who speaks for them? Does this Muslim group speak for them? I don't think so. But this is just more of the same hypocrisy of Gela and her friends. That's you, mi amigos. But this is just one lie after another. Pamela Geller has the same freedom of expression that the KKK goons. I'm a KKK goon, okay? This is the level of ad hominem attacks. According to them, Mother Teresa is a religious radical like Sheikh Karadawi.
Yes.
Seriously, there's a very good article this week Carolyn Glick wrote about this cancellation called Moral Equivocation in Jihad. I suggest you read it. Mind you, in this page of defamation, libel, and smears, there's not one quote from me. Nothing I ever said.
I want to
thank you. We can mill around and chat. We'll exchange cards. Thank you for coming out on a beautiful Sunday to fight for freedom. Your children will thank you. Believe me, you are a godsend. You are divine, and I am proud to stand with you. God bless you. There's much about the non-Jews as well, but this is Islamic Jew hatred. I want you to understand the compulsion behind the hatred of Israel and the Jewish people, where it comes from, why they cited, like this guy says, our hatred of the Jews is based on our faith. And these are the Quranic texts. I'd love for you to pass it out. I'd love for you, because you need to understand the ideology that motivates this genocide.